Hello, my name is Dr. Jim DeCanto. I'm an anesthesiologist from the United States with 27 years of clinical practice experience, chiefly in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. I'm here to talk to you about using a video laryngoscope system from Heine, a German manufacturer of high-quality optics. A product known as the Vision Pro. This is a combined direct laryngoscopy and video laryngoscopy device with disposable interchangeable blades. To begin this discussion, we're going to talk about the methods by which to properly and optimally perform an intubation. I'm going to begin by positioning my simulated patient. The patient in this case has an ear equal to the level of their sternal notch, which is doubly important, especially in obese patients. I'm going to be demonstrating the technique of tracheal intubation using a stylated tracheal tube with our video laryngoscope. I'll begin with holding the laryngoscope in my left hand, pushing on the mentum, and then performing something known as a scissor maneuver with my right hand. I'll then place the laryngoscope in such a manner that I come in from the right side of the tongue so I can use the flange of the Macintosh-shaped blade to contain the tongue. So I slip from the base of tongue into vallecula. Be very, very gentle. Well, I'm going to use video to make sure I do an absolute perfect job of engaging the vallecula. In this case, I'm looking at a grade one view under direct laryngoscopy, but I'm going to complete this procedure under video laryngoscopy. I now have plenty of room for tracheal tube delivery on the right side of the laryngoscope blade because I came in from the right and moved towards the left, and now I'm pretty much almost solidly midline, and I have a wonderful view of the larynx. So I'll ask my assistant to go ahead and hand me the tracheal tube. I have ample room now for tracheal tube delivery on the right side of the laryngoscope. It's easy to deliver the tracheal tube under these conditions. Let's go ahead and remove our stylet. This system has illuminated and magnified the hypopharynx in such a manner that this procedure is seamless. Let's go ahead and place some air into the cuff of the tracheal tube. I'm going to double check the position on video that I don't have an esophageal intubation. Now I'll just very gently rotate the laryngoscope out of the oral pharynx. As I connect the patient to my breathing circuit, whether it be a bag valve device or a ventilator, I want to make sure that I haven't placed the tracheal tube into the right main stem or even the left main stem. That can happen, but right main stem is more common. So as I'm ventilating, I have breath sounds, equal breath sounds left is right, nothing over the epigastrium. And I have end tidal waveform CO2 to signify that I have proper placement of the tracheal tube. This is a combined direct and video laryngoscopy system. The illumination and magnification of the system allows me to communicate with my assistants. And should I experience any difficulties during the procedure, my assistants or even my colleagues can assist me or even perform procedures such as external laryngeal manipulation or changing of the patient's position to facilitate intubation.